One of my favorite things about being a pilot and flying airplanes is the adventure that comes with it. Today, we're going to leave Green Turtle Key, fly from Treasure Key back to Fort Lauderdale.
It's a windy one.
Fly away for the summer, hey. Take a trip for the summer, hey, hey, hey. Fly away for the summer, hey. Take a trip for the summer, hey.
Nate on board. Nate, thanks for having us on board. We're flying a brand new Cirrus SR-22T. And like we said, being a pilot and the adventures that come with it is a lot of fun.
Absolutely.
We had a great time over here at Green Turtle Key on Abaco Island, and we're going to be flying back to Fort Lauderdale Executive Airport in Florida today.
This is Treasure Key Airport. MY18MET report.
I could also just do this.
At 16 hours, 2 minutes, Zulu. Wind, 170. Degrees at 16 knots. Visibility 10 kilometers. Clouds scattered 2,600 feet. Altimeter 3,001 inches of mercury.
All right, we got the airport information here. The automated weather got a nice stiff wind out of the southeast. South.
I think we're good.
Let's see. Where should we knock out our run up at, Nate?
Yeah, let's just go over there.
A lot of airplanes here today. We were in the Cirrus line of parking here. Looks like somebody else invaded it.
Yeah, a few of them have cleared out. Cherokee 6 took somebody's spot. You're good over here.
Get over there. Gotta be very careful. We wouldn't want to put a dent in this airplane.
No, I might get in a little bit of trouble for that one.
So we'll just pull up right over here and knock out our runner. Run-up is complete. I'll tell you, it's a pretty simple run-up on this thing.
Treasure traffic, Cirrus 176 Q Mike. We'll be back taxiing on runway 14 for departure to the west. Treasure.
All right, we're pulling past the hold short bars here. Clear to the left, and we'll see a little bit better once we get closer to the runway if we're clear to the right. Not hearing anybody on the radio.
Nope.
How are we looking down there, Nate?
Looks clear to the right.
We'll start our back taxi here. It's a long runway here. And
yeah.
It's pretty wide.
It is 7,000 feet.
Wow.
By 150.
I know, I've seen big Gulf Streams come in here before. Yeah, we had a great time in Green Turtle Key. We did some bone fishing. We saw a tiger shark, a lot of turtles. Pretty good time.
Cool. That was fun. And our plan, we filed IFR, so we're going to take off here. And then we'll talk to Miami Center once we're airborne and pick up our IFR clearance.
Sounds good. Yeah, the base of their airspace is 7,000 feet, so we'll climb right around 7,000 and pick up our IFR clearance.
Yep. All right, so we'll be doing a U-turn here, and then once we get straightened down the runway, he'll gradually put the power into full power, and we'll go all the way forward with the throttle. Rotate, it's gonna be 77 knots, flaps up at 90, and then anything from 0 to 600 feet, if we lose an engine, we'll land straight ahead. 600 feet to 2,000, we'll immediately pull the parachute handle, and then above 2,000, we'll troubleshoot.
Sounds good.
All right, I'm just sending out a call here, and we'll be on our way. Treasure, Gray Cirrus on runway 14, departing, Treasure.
All right, gonna slowly advance the power up. Takeoff power is set.
Roger.
Little temperature pressures all look good in the green. And there's our rotation speed. She gets up and goes. Probably gonna get a little rowdy here at the tops of these trees.
Yep.
With this wind. Yep, there it is. As expected. There's Green Turtle Key right off our left wing over there. All right.
Lots of forest on the right.
You can clear to the right.
Go ahead and get flaps up.
Got flaps selected. Look out the wing there, you'll see the flaps coming up.
All aircraft inbound from off travel.
Indicated.
Frequency 118.06. 8-6-3-1-3-7-9-6-5.
A little smoother up here.
There we go. Yeah, the Treasure Key, it's always known to get rowdy, right?
Cap's available.
Cap's available out of 600 feet. Gets rowdy down there at this airport. It's always been like that throughout the years that I've flown into that airport.
Yeah, the trees provide some good shelter, and then you get right at the top of that. Start riding the Bronco.
Yeah. There's a good look of Abaco Island.
I got it. Mars Island.
And we'll be going right down following Grand Bahama Island on our route today.
Hey. Yeah, buddy.
So I say we'll stay a little bit low until we get to the other side of these clouds. We'll try to find a hole to pop up through them. So we have our PFDs on.
Yep. Got our PFDs on. Still have our raft in the back and our go bag. Which
we're just about to go over, get out of the gliding distance of land here. So we briefed each other on what we'll do in case we ever had to do a water ditching before the flight.
Yep. You can see it's pretty windy. The white caps are out there.
Oh, yeah. It's not going to be fun in a raft down there today.
Oh.
So here we go. We'll be able to climb right after these clouds, I believe.
Ah, there's some nice blue sky.
We'll take it.
That's what we're looking for.
So what we'll do is we're going to actually go right over here to the right, and then we'll climb right up that, above that over there. And then we'll be able to be at 7,000 and contact Miami. So I'm just pitching up right now to get back to our climb speed. There we go, we'll put the autopilot on.
70 center, flex at 585, level 1.
And let the airplane do some of the work for us.
Miami center, NASA,
we take a look down here at 4 flight, you'll see this is our routing today. We're going to go direct to Freeport, which is Zulu Foxtrot Papa, and then join Bahama Route 6-8 Victor into Fort Lauderdale Executive. We do have the TFR you'll see there in red. That's President Trump is in the Palm Beach area, so we just need to be on a filed flight plan with the squawk in our transponder to be able to enter that area. So we're basically going right down the Grand Bahama Island, and a lot of time in the summertime, you'll get a line of storms that follows this whole island here. So like when you take off out of Marsh Harbor, Treasure, or Spanish up here, you normally have to decide, do I want to go north of the island and follow, get around the storms, or just go south of the island and follow down? Because it'll usually be a big wall of storms right in that area.
Yep.
And you can see Grand Bahama Island up in the distance there.
Silver Wings 88, Roger.
Miami Center, Cirrus 176 Kilo Mike. Good afternoon.
Missed that last check. Say it again, please.
That was Cirrus 176 Kilo Mike. We're currently 15 miles to the west of Treasure Key, 7500 climbing, and a request IFR to Fort Lauderdale Executive.
November 176 Kilo Mike, Miami Center, Squawk 0032.
0032, 6 Kilo Mike.
Exo jet
we got that set up in our transponder now. He asks us to put 0032. Now he's looking on his screen for our contact with that number next to it.
6 Kilo Mike, radar contact east of Freeport, 50 miles, stay out to leaving.
6 Kilo Mike, leaving 8700.
November 6 Kilo Mike, clear to Fort Lauderdale Executive Airport, direct Freeport, join Bahama Route 68 Victor until Fort Lauderdale VOR, direct Fort Lauderdale Executive Airport, maintain 10,000.
I cleared to Fort Lauderdale Executive via direct Freeport, Bahama Route 68 Victor to Fort Lauderdale, then FXC, climb maintain 10,000, 6 kilometers.
See if he'll give us a little left of the
mic. Read back correct. Freeport altimeter 2997.
97, and we may need a slight deviation to the left for 6 kilometers.
6 kilometers, left deviation is approved. Proceed direct Freeport when able and advised.
Perfect. 6 kilometers, we'll go, thanks.
All right, good deal. So we got our clearance. We anticipated seeing these clouds. We don't really want to go in and be a little smoother ride right to the south of them. He gave us permission to deviate, and when able, direct Freeport. There's our little chime, 200 feet to go. What we have set up in our altitude pre-selector, 10,000 feet. The airplane will level off.
All right, center 86 on Mike Alpha.
And we'll let it build up some momentum. We'll set cruise power. All right, so we're looking at the manifold pressure here.
Give me 1 second.
Pull
here.
The power lever back to 30.5. All right, right in there.
Yep. And then you can lean back to about 17.
Negative, sir.
Right in there looks good, right?
That looks good.
Cool. Cruise power is set. All right, look at this, guys. I'm going to show you a cool little airport down here. I'll see if you guys can see the runway there. It's right near the beach. It's called Deepwater Key. I used to fly King Airs and caravans in there. I got a King Air video a long time ago that I made landing in there. And it's a pretty cool little strip right there. That's called Deepwater Key right down there. See if you guys can actually spot the runway. It's kind of hard to see. So if you come down here, like I say, it's always better to be lucky than good. Come down, if you scroll out, you're going to see. This morning, there was a lot of big storms in our route. And now, it's pushed through to the north. We got a nice, clear opening into Fort Lauderdale. You can see all the traffic out here. A lot of airplanes. So we got a system to the south of our route and to the north of our route. But we got lucky with the weather today. You can see there's the highway in the sky. Back to Freeport. Alright, we started down the arrival on Bahama 68 Victor here.
Approach, here's 176 kilo mic, 3400 descending 3.
There's 176 kilo mic, Miami approach, good afternoon. Advise when you have the ATIS Lima at Executive Plant RNAV runway 27 approach.
6 kilo mic, we have Lima.
176 kilo mic, very good. When able, proceed to 4SU and intercept the runway 27, final approach course.
Direct 4SU, 6 kilo mic, and intercept final approach course.
Alright, so we're going to put in the ILS for 27 right. And we're going to go direct 4SU.
Server 109er Lima Uniform Contact, Boca Tower 118.42 for pattern entry instructions, and we'll talk to you later.
There we go, we got all set up in the computer of the airplane. I'm going to show you guys something. If you look down here at 4 Flight on the iPad, this is a little reason why we departed a day early out of Treasure Key instead of leaving tomorrow. We scroll up, look at the line of weather headed our way. You can see all the lightning strikes in it. It's just massive. A massive line of weather. That's a really good reason to be able to have your own airplane and be able to plan properly, leave when you need to leave. So there's a massive line of weather headed towards us. Thankfully, we'll be on the ground before it hits.
Contact tower 120.9 or have a nice day.
120.9, Tacoma 18.
Sir, 6 kilo mic is 12 miles from 4SU, cross 4SU 2000, clear straight in RNAV 27, approach executive.
Cross 4SU 2000, cleared RNAV 27, 6 kilo mic.
6 kilo mic, affirmative, and best forward speed for me of citation traffic will be in trail of you.
6 kilo mic, roger.
Alright, we're going to VS down to 2000. We're going to keep our best forward speed. On this landing, we're going to expect a 25 knot dusting crosswind from the left. So it should be a tricky landing here for me. I know the viewers, you guys, you don't want it to be easy on me. It's always more entertaining to see me struggle. There's Watermakers.
2000 heading 315.
Buddy
Rubin. Watermaker 6445, Miami departure, ready to contact. Good afternoon. Turn right, heading 050. Climb and maintain.
He'll be
4000.
Coming in.
050 to the right, up to 4000. Watermaker 6445.
Actually, he just took off. He's going out to Staniel Key. He's clearing in somewhere before that, though. They're hiring there at Makers Air out of Fort Lauderdale. You need 1,200 total time. You want to fly caravans around the Bahamas? Be sure to hit them up.
Nice.
They're hiring. You guys are thinking about becoming a pilot, either professionally or just for fun, you know. My friend Jason Shepard has an online ground school at m0a.com. He also has a free book that he wrote. You just got to pay for shipping and handling, the Private Pilot Blueprint. It's basically a guide that will save you time and money as you're getting your private pilot license. It's pretty good stuff. It's in the description below. All right, so since we've been cleared for the approach, we'll go into approach mode.
So what that does is it arms your glide path up there, so that'll also follow the vertical guidance down.
Nice. They can see down, if you look off the wing there, a lot of white caps. That wind is whipping out here today.
Executive Tower 120.9, take care.
Go to Tower 6, Kilo Mike, have a good one. Tower 0 is 176, Kilo Mike, force you inbound.
And 176 Kilo Mike, Executive Tower, you want to circle to 13, wind is 180 at 17, gust 31.
That sounds like a good plan. 6 Kilo Mike, circle 13.
Number 6 Kilo Mike, roger, continue inbound for 27, I'll work it out with Miami.
6 Kilo Mike, roger, continue inbound 27.
Alright, I know you guys like to see me challenge, but I don't really feel like dealing with a 30 knot crosswind, gusting crosswind.
No.
So, she's going to work it out with the Miami approach. To get us a circle to land into 13, we'll do a, most likely a right circle, which will be the left traffic.
Vertical
then.
Number track.
6 Kilo Mike, wind able, circle northwest, enjoying left base for runway 13. Runway 13, clear to land.
All right, circle northwest and join left base for 13, clear to land 13, 6 Kilo Mike.
All right, everything worked out good. So wind able, when we feel confident and comfortable with it, we'll I'll disconnect the autopilot here. And we'll circle for left traffic to 13, and we are clear to land.
Cool.
Well, all we have to worry about now is landing the airplane. All right, I think I'm going to disconnect the autopilot, have a little fun hand flying here before
sure.
we land. Hit the autopilot disconnect button.
I'm going to get the visual approach to 13 loaded.
Thank you. So we're coming up on the shoreline here, guys. You're going to see a big change in how this airplane's handling. See how it's nice and smooth right now? Right now we're over the water. Wait till you see once we get over the land here. I see a big difference in how this airplane's riding through the sky. Beautiful view of the shoreline down there. So we're going to expect a right crosswind on this one. And now that we're over the land, we'll get the unequal heating of the Earth's surface. And that's where now we're going to start to get the bumps right here.
Yep.
All right, we're right around 30% power. We're within the speed limitations. With the flaps selected. Look on the wind there, you'll see the flaps coming down and indicated.
One,
so we're
three,
basically
two,
on a midfield left downwind.
Land 27818, loop back straight.
1-3. Wind
200
at 19, gust
31. Wow, 200 at gusting 31. And we'll go full flaps.
75982, executive tower flight westbound.
Elected.
And join a left downwind for runway 13.
Okay, westbound, left down for 139.
We'll start to turn our left base here. Yeah, it's bumpy. It's gusting 31. I remember my first time flying in winds of 31. I was like, how can people fly airplanes in this kind of wind? So we're starting our left base.
Number 982, fly westbound third. Traffic is 3
I'm going to hold a little bit more speed in on this approach than normal just because we've had a low-level wind shear reported.
Let's keep 85 plus.
Yeah, it's it just dipped down to 80 there with the gust.
500.
All right, here we go, guys. It's about to turn a short final here for 313.
Wind 190 at 22, gust 31.
We're going to have quite a little crab angle here. 90
over
knots.
92, sir,
Roger.
Place south of the
good.
Final for runway 27.
Go-arounds are always an option.
Continue
you don't feel like the way something feels,
you
can always go around. So we're going to let the airplane hold the crab.
Say it again.
When I get into the flare, I'll kick out the crab and set her down. Okay,
start.
Here we come. Start easing the power back. Gotta start to kick the crab out.
Number 982, just to make this work a little better, turn 20 degrees to the right and join a left base for runway 13.
Not bad.
Traffic.
Look at that.
We'll nice.
We touched down pretty smooth on the appropriate landing gear.
The fly northwest down and join
that
the left
nice.
Base.
It was actually nice smooth
okay,
touchdown. Touchdown. You want to touch down on the you know the side the wind's coming from first with your mains.
Number 982.
That's what we did.
Number 2 for the field.
Well done, man.
Yeah, thank you, buddy. I'll take that any day.
Kilo Mike, contact ground on Charlie. Get it.
6 Kilo Mike, we're going to take a left going across to the contact ground.
Welcome to Fort Lauderdale Executive, guys. That was quite a exciting flight.
Well done. Good the landing light.
Old short fires here. Bus doesn't come to a stop.
Executive ground, here's 176 Kilo Mike and Charlie going to customs.
From 176 Kilo Mike, executive ground taxi, right turn, Golf, Golf 7.
Golf, Golf 7, 6 Kilo Mike.
Alright, so yeah, welcome to Fort Lauderdale. We're going to go into customs here. That's the first step after you land, flying internationally. The adventures of pilot life is a lot of fun.
There's my office building.
Right over here, if you want.
You guys want to talk about a Cirrus?
You'll see Nate right over here.
Cirrus Florida on Instagram?
Yeah, definitely. I'll link Nate's Instagram in the description below. Be sure to hit him up and give him a follow. And if you want to see one of these
executives
things
on
in person, he'll be there to
Engine
show you.
395 ground.
The customs building right up here in front of us. We'll clear in there, and then once we're done with that, we'll go put the airplane in the hangar. Hope you guys enjoyed that flight. If you did, please smash that thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel, and we'll talk to you again someday soon.
Thanks for joining. Fly away for the summer, hey. Take a trip for the summer, hey, hey, hey. Fly away for the summer, hey. Take a trip for the summer, hey. Fly away for the summer, hey. Take a trip for the summer, hey. Friends.